to analyze the statistical significance of the identified peptide spectrum matches, we will introduce the concept of spectral dictionary. Imagine that a PSM search of 1,000 spectra from a human sample against the human proteome results in 100 peptide spectrum matches with a score exceeding a threshold. What is the fraction of erroneous peptide spectrum matches among these 100 peptide spectrum matches? I'll give you a hint of how it may be possible to answer this question, and here's the hint. Let's repeat the same experiment for a randomly generated decoy proteome of the same size as the human proteome. Of course, we don't care about peptide spectrum matches identified in the decoy proteome, they are simply statistical artifacts. What we care about is the number of such hits in decoy proteome. For example, if you identify 5 peptide spectrum matches in decoy proteome, then you expect that 5 over 100 or 5% of PSMs identified in the real human proteomes are incorrect. And therefore, we define the notion of false discovery rate as simply the ratio of the number of peptide spectrum matches identified in decoy proteome over the number of peptide spectrum matches identified in the real proteome. And when we run this experiment on T-Rex spectra, then we will identify 27 peptide spectrum matches in UniProt Plus real database and only 1 peptide spectrum match in decoy proteome of the same size for a threshold equal 100. Which means that in this experiment, FDR will be a respectable 3.7%. But does it mean that we just found approximately 27 T-Rex peptide? Not quite, because many of the peptides that we identify are simply laboratory contaminants that are present in every experiment. For example, keratin from human skin. There are currently millions of tiny particles of my skin and skin of the people who pass through this room floating in the air in this room. The question that we have to answer to figure out which of the identified peptide spectrum matches are correct is how to estimate the statistical significance of individual peptide spectrum matches rather than the bulk false discovery rate for the entire sample. To answer this question, we will bring in a monkey, give this monkey a typewriter, and let monkey type random keys on this typewriter for a very long time. Afterwards, let's check how many correctly spelled English words monkey generated. We can use Webster dictionary to check it or whatever monkey dictionary to check it. In this particular case, the monkey generated 13 correctly spelled English words. Does it mean that the monkey can spell? Well, to answer this question, we probably need to evaluate what is the expected number of words from dictionary that appear in a randomly generated text. Or in other words, we need to solve the following, the monkey and the typewriter problem. Find the expected number of strings from dictionary appearing in a randomly generated text. But what it has to do with mass spectrometry? Well, at the same time, we want to solve the following mass spectrometry problem to find expected number of high-scoring peptides, which is find the expected number of high-scoring peptides against a given spectrum in a decoy proteome. The input to this problem is a spectrum, an integer n, and a scorer threshold. And the output is the expected number of peptides in a decoy proteome of length n that score at least threshold against spectrum. You may be wondering what is the similarity or any relevance of expected number of high-scoring peptide problem and the monkey and the typewriter problem. And it is not clear that these problems are equivalent, but they are. To explain why this is actually the same problem, I will introduce the notion of spectral dictionary. Dictionary of spectrum under a given threshold is simply the set of all peptides with a score at least threshold against spectrum. There will be many of these peptides, and as soon as we generated the set dictionary for a given spectrum, we can reformulate the expected number of high-scoring peptides problem as the following problem. We want to find the expected number of peptides from dictionary occurring in decoy proteome of length n. And let's make one more step to reformulate this problem. We reformulated its output. Let's now reformulate its input. And the new input will be simply all peptides from dictionary of spectrum and an integer n, and output the expected number of strings from dictionary occurring in a decoy proteome of length n. Take a look at this problem. This is exactly the monkey and the dictionary problem for a specific set of peptide given by dictionary of spectrum under a given threshold.